Today's class, we are going to learn nuclear power reactors and its components. Nuclear power reactor is a device which is used to initiate and control a nuclear fusion reactions to generate electricity. When slow-moving neutron interacted over uranium-235, it forms unstable uranium-236. Which decompose to form krypton-92 and barium-141 as a fissionable products with the release of 3 neutrons. During this process, a large amount of energy is released, around 200 MeV. The formed these 3 neutrons further interact with the 3 uranium-235 and it forms its fissionable product with the release of 9 neutrons. That 9 neutron further reacts with another 9 uranium-235 and it produces again 27 neutrons. So this process continued. This reaction is called chain reaction. Normally, uranium exists in mainly two isotopes, uranium-235 and uranium-238. Out of that, only uranium-235 is feasible. So when this reaction is controlled, that is when the number of neutrons which are going to emit is controlled, we can harness that energy for the betterment of the society. So such reactions we called as controlled nuclear reactions. During this controlled nuclear reactions, so whatever 3 neutrons are generated after each step, out of that 3, on an average 1 or 2 neutrons will be absorbed by absorbing material, and as a result, at every stage, the neutron flux will be maintained nearly 1 or slightly above 1. But if this is not controlled, then it becomes uncontrolled nuclear reaction, and which is causes a explosion like atomic bomb. And in today's class, we are going to learn about nuclear power reactor. Here we are going to learn the conversion of this nuclear energy into electricity. And this nuclear power reactor, normally 1 kg of uranium can produce a power around 950 megawatt. So let us discuss essential components of nuclear power plants. Nuclear power plant contains mainly 7 components. Number 1, nuclear fuel. Second, fuel cladding. Each fuel rods is surrounded by some material. It is just like a coating, that is we called as fuel cladding. Later on we are going to discuss in detail. Third component is a coolant. The role of the coolant is to transfer the heat generated by nuclear reactions into heat exchanger. Then the fourth component is moderator. The role of the moderator is slow down that fast moving neutrons which are generated during nuclear fusion process. Control rod. These are the control rods. These control rod has a capacity to absorb the neutrons. By absorbing the neutrons, we can control the nuclear reactions. So whether to start the nuclear reactions or stop the nuclear reaction will be controlled with the help of these control rods. Sensing elements. So as this particular process should be a controlled, hence we are using different sensing element like a thermal sensor which monitors the temperature of this core reactor, because it should not cross certain limit. If it crosses the certain limit, then it will results a explosion. That is what is happened in Fukushima. And to maintain this cold condition, you know, the water should circulate. So circulation of this water will be monitored by a pump. So in case of Fukushima, that cooling pump was not able to work, and as a result temperature was increased tremendously and causes explosion. Next, seventh component is an external component. The external component is a protective component, or it is a protective shield which covers this nuclear reactor and protect environment. The working of this nuclear power plant, nuclear fuel, that is uranium-235 or plutonium-235, is surrounded with a cladding and surrounded with moderator. So in between these fuel bundles of control rods are inserted, and the whole assembly is placed in a coolant. The role of the coolant is to maintain temperature of this nuclear reactor. This coolant will take out the energy or the heat generated into heat exchanger. In the heat exchanger, the water will get boiled and steam is generated. Using that steam, a turbine will rotate and it generates electricity. So this is the complete working principle of nuclear power plant. So let us discuss all the components of nuclear power plants one by one. The first component is nuclear fuel. It is one of the important component in a nuclear reactor. It is used for sustaining chain reaction. Normally UO2, that is uranium dioxide pellets, are used having a mass of 2.66 gram or 2.10 gram. In some of the nuclear reactor, metallic uranium rods are used. That uranium may be a natural. So this natural uranium generally contains just 0.72% of uranium-235, which is fissible, but rest will be uranium-238, which is not fissionable. And some of the nuclear reactors we used enriched uranium, which contain around 3.5% uranium-235. Generally for defense purpose, that is for atomic bomb, the enriched uranium will be used, which contain uranium-235 on an average around 10 to 20%. But in nuclear power plants we use maximum 3.5% uranium-235. Even some nuclear power plants, plutonium-239 is used as a fuel. So this uranium pellets, which is generally made by UO2, it is enclosed in a cladding tube. Cladding tube is just like a coating over that uranium pellets. And number of such tubes are made into fuel bundles, and this arranged in a fixed geometry, then the fuel is cooled by flow of water or D2O. Here water or D2O act as a coolant, so the temperature should be below a melting point of cladding materials. This is the image of how the fuel bundles will look from the top. And after every 12 months or 18 months, depending on a type of nuclear reactor, these fuel rods, it is to be changed. So when we change these nuclear fuel rods, it does not mean that all the fuel content in that fuel rod got exhausted. It looked like a new one, but still we need to change this. इवन द फ्यूअल रॉड्स विच इज विच वी आर गोइंग टू चेंज आफ्टर 12 months और 18 months, इवन इट कंटेन्स यूरेनियम 235, बट वी नीड टू चेंज इट ड्यू टू दीज 4 रीजन्स. इन केस ऑफ नेचुरल यूरेनियम द डिक्रीज इन फिजाइल कंटेंट ऑफ फ्यूएल ड्यू टू लो फ्यूजन प्रोसेस. एज वी नो दैट नेचुरल यूरेनियम कंटेन अ वेरी लेस परसेंटेज ऑफ यूरेनियम 235. सो आफ्टर 1 year और 1.5 year, एज सम ऑफ द क्वांटिटी ऑफ दिस यूरेनियम 235 गॉट रिएक्टेड, सो द क्वांटिटी ऑफ यूरेनियम 235 प्रेजेंट इन सच नेचुरल यूरेनियम इज वेरी लेस. सो ऑटोमेटिकली इट अफेक्ट्स द एफिशियंसी ऑफ न्यूक्लियर पावर प्लांट एंड हेंस इट इज टू बी चेंज्ड. ऑल्सो there will be a decrease in reactivity of fuel due to accumulation of neutron absorbing fission product. As we know that then this nuclear fuel, say natural uranium, is covered with a cladding, and during this nuclear reactions to generate heat, whatever byproducts or whatever fissionable products are formed, it is going to accumulate within the cladding. These fissionable product sometimes has a capacity to absorb the neutron, and it affects the efficiency of nuclear power plant. So these are the two reasons why normally natural uranium, you know, rods should be changed normally after every 12 months. In case of enriched uranium and plutonium, due to deposition of fissionable product, the clad gets swell. There is a possibility that may break and causes some accident. And once, suppose the clad breaks, these fissionable product may mixed in the coolant, and with that it may come in heat exchangers. And once it comes in heat exchanger, there is a possibility that it may cause environmental pollutions by the radiations or by that isotopic nuclei. Also, it damages the integrity of a clad due to corrosion by coolant and moderator. That is, during this 12 months or 18 months period, as the coolant or moderator continuously flowing over the surface of clad, so there is a possibility that the surface of that clad may undergoes corroded, and this corroded surface may cause again a leakage of fissionable products. In some of the nuclear reactor, the same component can be used as moderator as well as cooler. The second component of nuclear reactor is a cladding. It is a primary barrier between highly radioactive fission products and environment. So basically, to choose a proper cladding, so these three components should be considered. The first point is the cladding material should be chemically compatible with the fuel, coolant and moderator. Means cladding material should not react with the fuel, that is uranium 235, should not react with the coolant as well as moderator. It also should withstand a pressure due to fuel swelling. As already I said, the fuel gets swelled due to deposition of fissionable product, and as the fissionable product go on depositing, so there is a possibility that the cladding material should experience a high pressure. So this cladding material should withstand the pressure due to fuel swelling. It should have a very low neutron absorbing capacity. So these are the three basic criteria taken into consideration during the choice of a proper cladding material. So this cladding material will be chosen depending on a type of nuclear reactor where it is used. Normally, aluminium is used in a research reactor. Cognox alloy is used in gas-cooled power reactor. Cognos is an alloy of magnesium, aluminium and beryllium. In case of water-cooled power reactor, zirkaloy 2 or zirkaloy 4 is used as a cladding material. Zirkaloy is also an alloy made by zirconium, tin, iron, chromium and nickel. So in zirkaloy 2, the percentage of iron is 0.15%, but that of zirkaloy 4, it contains around 0.2% of iron. A third component of nuclear power plant is a coolant. It is very very important component in maintaining the temperature within the nuclear core. Role of the coolant is the heat generated by fission is removed and flow through by the coolant flowing through the reactor, and this coolant will exchange that heat with the heat exchanger, and that heat exchanger will boil off water and generates steam, and that steam will use to rotate a turbine and electricity is generated. Criterias are used to choose a proper coolant are: the coolant should have good thermal conductivity, they should have high specific heat, it should be compatible with fuel and other structural material, it should have low neutron absorbing cross sections. Normally, the water, heavy water, helium, sodium, that is a liquid sodium, are commonly used as a coolant. A next component of nuclear reactor is moderator. The role of moderator is to maintain the speed of neutrons, because if we want to undergo or if you want to carry out controlled nuclear reaction, then there is a need of slow moving neutrons, because fast moving neutrons may undergo uncontrolled nuclear reactions and may cause explosion. To avoid that, the speed of the neutrons should be controlled. Slow, these moderators are commonly used. So normally it is used to slow down the speed of neutrons which are formed during fission process. Commonly, water, heavy water or graphites are used as moderator. And in some of the nuclear power plants, moderator and coolants will be same materials. Fifth component and very important component is a control rod. The role of the control rod is to absorb the neutrons generated in nuclear power plant. So it is going to start or stop the nuclear reactor. So control rods will be adjusted in such a way that it should maintain neutron flux slightly more than unity. It should not be too high, it should not be too low. If the neutron flux is less than unity, that is less than 1, then automatically the efficiency of nuclear power plant will decrease, and if it crosses 1.5 or 2, it may result a uncontrolled reaction and may cause explosion. So maintaining neutron flux is entirely in a hand of control rods. So normally boron, silver, indium, cadmium and zinc, these elements are commonly used in control rods. The next component in the nuclear reactor is sensing elements. These sensing elements are very important in monitoring the process of nuclear power plants. The first sensing element is a flow nozzle. So this flow nozzle will monitor coolant flow. So the coolant flow within the nuclear core is monitored by flow nozzle, and it in other way it is help us to maintain a temperature of nuclear power plant. The second component is thermocouple. Thermocouple is used to monitor the temperature. Third, there exists some system to detect the leakage of fission product. At every stage, even whenever the workers, those who are working in a nuclear power plant, they will be tested the radiations at every block. That means whenever a working people in nuclear power plants are moving from one room to another room, every stage they will be checked about radiation which they are exposed. So for that, radiation detection machineries will be installed. The seventh and a very important component will be external component of core. This particular component is covering whole nuclear power plant. Normally, the core of the nuclear power plant is coated with, or it is covered with, first reflector. The role of the reflector is to reflect back the neutrons which are emitted during the nuclear fission process. So using this reflector, the neutrons are not allowed to go out of this nuclear field. Then after the reflector, thermal shield will be made. Thermal shield is used to maintain a temperature, so environment should not affect with the heat generated by this nuclear reactor. So this thermal shield is important, which contain an alternate layer of water and steel sheets. After this thermal shield, it is covered with 3 to 5 meters thick concrete to maintain nuclear power plant safely. So these are the different components present in nuclear power plants. Thank you.